Hello all, this is Mohammed Hanif from RJKT Basar. I welcome you on this lab session on digital signal processing. Today we'll be starting working on MATLAB, and today I will show you how we can write a simple program to generate a sine wave and how we can use a plot function in MATLAB to draw two-dimensional diagrams. Okay, so let's start. Starting with, for every program, we'll start with functions CLC. So this is the function is used to clear the command window. So here, this is command window. So whatever the program will write here, it will be executed through command window, and output results will be displayed in this command window. So help of this one, so you can see here, let's I'm assigning x is equals to 4, and after running this, you can see that in this window x 4 value 4 is assigned to x, and if you want to clear this, then we have to use CLC here. And if we run this program, now you can see that this previously whatever executed in command window has been cleared. So this is the keyword used to clear the command window. Similarly, here you can see that this is a workspace I have previously used for this one, just for showing what we can do with this workspace. I have remained it here. So now if you write clear all, so it will clears the workspace. So if you run this program now, so it will be cleared. So now you can see, that whatever the previously executed program have saved its values in workspace have been cleared by this clear all. Similarly, we have to write a close all. So this command is used to clear the windows previously used in MATLAB. Maybe it may be used to show the different graphs and any histograms, any something like that. Okay, so it will be clearing all the windows which are related to MATLAB. Okay, so whenever you are writing the program, make a habit of writing these three, so that it will be very helpful. Otherwise, some garbage values will be retained same as it is in the used variable, and it may mislead in our program. Okay, so now, so today we'll be writing a program on how we can generate a simple sine wave and how we can draw it using a plot function in two dimensions. Okay, so first writing one fs. So this is fs for sampling frequency. So I am writing it as a 4000. So this is sampling frequency. And next, defining ts as 1 upon fs and defining a t intervals. So here we are using a colon operator. So colon operator, normally if you write like this, t colon 5, it means with the help of this colon operator, we are going to generate a series of values to variable t. As it is written 0 colon 5, that means the first value will be started 0, and then it will goes up to 5 with the increment of plus 1. By default, it will increment by plus 1. But if you want to increment in a steps, so that steps we can define here. So in the middle we have to write the increment steps. So that one we are writing here as a ts. So that means in our this program, the t value will be start at 0 and it goes up to 1 with the increment values of ts, and which already we have defined here. Okay, and now we'll take f as a frequency. and we'll write some values as 4. So we are trying to design a signal which is having a frequency of 4 hertz. So analog frequency. Now taking one variable called x and defining it with sine function. So sine of 2 pi f into t. So it is defining a sine function to output x. Okay. Now we'll try to use the plot function to draw a plot of for this x variable. So now we'll write plot, and x will be drawn with respect to t. So that means t comma x. Okay, that's it. This is a small program to generate a sine wave, and now we'll run this program. To run this program, either you can press on F5 or you can go with this green button. Now here you can see that this is the output for the sine wave, and as you can see here, we have mentioned frequency 4. So this is the output. We now you can see that they have generated 4 cycles. Okay. The thing is, after writing the program, you can see that it is like having no information. So like we don't have any x labels, that means x axis and y axis, and there is no title. So now we'll try to define those things. So after writing the program plot, now we'll write x label. So x label defines one name in x axis. So normally we'll have x axis, it will be time in seconds. Okay, and similarly we'll define y label, so it will be amplitude, and then we'll define title for this, say it is a sine wave. Now once again we run this program. As you know that by pressing F5 we can run, or you can click on this. Now here, now we can see that here on x-axis the information is given, the time in seconds, and then amplitude is given in y-axis, and then one title is given. Okay, so this is one way to define the plot and then mentioning labels. Now by default you have seen that the waveform was in blue color. To make it in other colors, or to make it in different variations, so simply here in command window you try to write help plot. With this help command we can try to get more information on that particular functions defined in MATLAB. Okay, now just run this. You will going to get one documentation related to this plot. So here you can see the plot. It says that x comma y, it will defines y versus vector x, and then here you can see that if we write x, y and s, where the s is a character string, and in this point, that means third variable, if you write these values, then you are going to get a different variations in plot. So by default it was in blue color. If you want to change that color into any other, then just we can write go with red. So then means you have to write that comma here and then put R here. In single quotes you have to write R. Similarly, if you want a dashed lines, so here we can write dashes here. Now we will run this program. You can compare that. Earlier it was in blue color and it was in continuous. Now we'll get it will be in red color and it will be dashed one. See here. This is the output. Okay. Let you are having another function, let's cos, and if you want to build the two waveforms in a single window, how we can do that? So now for defining a y variable and defining it with cos, and then say same 2 cos 2 pi f and then t, and for defining this again we have to use plot t comma y, and as it is we'll be writing same labels and titles for this. So copying that and pasting here, just changing the title as cos. Now if you run, so we have to get two waveforms, but here you can see that we got only one waveform and the waveform is titled with cosine wave. That means whatever the program you have written here, so here though we have written plot two times, okay, we have been given with only plot which is defined at last. That means actually this has been executed first, but it is overwritten by this plot is written in lastly. So that means this will be executed and it will be overwritten. So that to have this previous one also, so what we have to write, we have to say that MATLAB to that please hold it on. So we have to write hold on here, okay, before the writing the plot, first plot. Now you can run the program here. Now you can see that we got two waveforms, right? But if we know that this red line, already we have mentioned it here, that is red line is defining the first plot, then it is very easy to understand. It is that red is defining the sine wave and blue is defining a cosine wave. Okay. And just in case, if we don't know that which waveform is representing what, then like removing this one, that means now we are not defining the sine wave with red color. So by default it will take different colors to sine wave and cosine wave, and just assuming that we don't know which is sine and which is cos, then we'll run this. Here you can see that both the waveforms are generated and one is started at zero, so obviously this will be a sine wave, and one is starting at one, so obviously this will be a cosine wave. But assuming that we don't know that which is representing in what color, so what to know that we have to write legend software, hold on, we'll write legend and now run the program. Now here you can see that the data 1 and data 2, so first data, so first plot is displayed here and that is will be in sine wave. Okay, so with the help of that legend we can write that. And one more thing, you can see that the axis is started at 0 and it goes up to 1 on x axis. Similarly on y axis, the axis started at minus 1 and it goes up to plus 1. Now we can change those axes here by writing axis and in the square brackets, it comes like this, x max and then x min, y max and y min. So here you have to define the values what is the maximum value you want to project on x-axis. So earlier it was in 1, so I am writing as a 2. Similarly, x min, so it started at 0, so I am writing here minus 2. And then y max was a plus 1, I'm mentioning it as a 2. And y min, it was minus 1, so I'm mentioning it's minus 2. So that I'm defining that axis. So let the axis will be going with these values. So once again, running this program. Okay, the error actually starting it will be x min and then x max, then y min, y max. Now here you can see that the x axis started at minimum value is minus 2, maximum value is plus 2. Similarly, y-axis minimum value is minus 2 and maximum value is plus 2. Okay. The two waveforms have been generated in a single window, and those two waveforms are overlapped each other. Just if you want to separate them, and then instead of using hold on and this legend, we can divide that two-dimensional window into a you can divide it into horizontal or vertical, and you can make a four any some required parts in that, and depends on that we can plot on those windows. So we'll be using a subplot here. So it says that it actually do required in terms of M, N and P. So here the M stands for rows and N stands for columns. So that means M cross N rows will be those many divisions we can do in a single window, and P tells that the position in that particular window. Okay. So here we are drawing two plots, one is for sine and another is for cos. Okay. So we'll try to take one row and then say two columns. Okay. So we are defining dividing that output window into one row and two columns, and then position it will say the first position. After the division, we are taking the first position and we are plotting the first plot for a sine wave. And similarly, for plotting the cos, once again we have to write before the plot, we have to write subplot and continue with the same thing, 1, 2, that means one row and two columns, and then say second position. So here on the second position, we want to plot a y variable. Now once again running this program, now you can observe that the window will be divided into two columns. So this is the first column, second column. So this is the first position, second position. And here you can see that as in plot, here this plot we have mentioned axis. So for this only we got the axis one, and for this one by default it has shown the default values. Okay. And here you can see that this is a sine wave title and this is a cosine wave title. Similarly you can, if you change this one to 2 and this is to 1, it means that we are going to divide the window into two rows and one column. Okay. So once again running this program, now here you can see that there are two rows and one column. Okay. I hope you have understand this. We have successfully generated a sine waveform, and then we have seen the different uses of plots and what is the x label, y label and title, and we have seen the use of hold on, And then we have seen legend, and then also we have seen the subplots. Like this, you can divide in any number of windows in the same window, and you can plot any number of the plots in this. Okay. I hope this is clear for this one. Thank you so much.